എൻ്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ അദ്ദേഹത്തിൽ നിന്ന് സഹോദരനായിട്ടാണോ എൻ്റെ മകനായിട്ടാണോ ഞാൻ കണ്ടിരിക്കണമെന്ന് എനിക്ക് പറയാൻ വാക്കുകളില്ല.
ദ ഗൈഡിങ് സ്പിരിറ്റ് ഫോർ ഈച്ച് ആൻഡ് എവറിത്തിങ് ദാറ്റ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് ഫോർ ദ അപ്ലിഫ്റ്റ്മെൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ആയുർവേദ ഇൻ ആയുർവേദ ഫാർമസി ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഫോർ ദ ഗ്രേറ്റർ കോസ് ഓഫ് ആയുർവേദ ഇൻ ദ ഹോൾ വേൾഡ്
വാസ് എ ഗോഡ് ഫാദർ ഫോർ മീ.
അവർ തന്നെ എനിക്ക് ദൈവങ്ങൾ
ഒരു ഗുരുനാഥൻ എന്ന് പറയാം.
ഒരു അമ്മ കിട്ട നമ്മ എന്ന ഒരു ഫീൽ നമ്മ കിടക്കുമോ അതേ തന്നെ ഇപ്പം കൃഷ്ണമാജിട്ട് ഇതുവരെയും പാത്രക്കെ
അപ്പോൾ സമയത്ത് പാപ്പക്ക് എത്ര ലഗ്താ
ഒരു പാത്രത്തിന് നമ്മൾ നമ്മുടെ നമുക്കൊരു എനർജി വന്നിരുന്നു
റിയൽ മോഡേൺ കർമ്മയോഗി.
എൻ്റെ അനുഭവത്തിൽ സാറ് നല്ലതെന്നാണ് ഞാൻ പറയുന്നത്.
ആരാണെന്ന് ചോദിച്ചാൽ മറുപടി പറയാനില്ല. ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് എല്ലാം ദൈവമാണെന്ന് ചോദിച്ചാൽ ദൈവം തന്നെയായിരുന്നു ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് എല്ലാ രീതിയിലും.
ഒരു വികസനം ഒരു പഠിപ്പാളി
സെൻറ്റൻസിൽ ഒതുക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല.
ചോദ്യമെല്ലാമായിരുന്നു
ഒരു മുതലാളിയുടെ മാതിരിയല്ല ഒരു ഗുരുവായിട്ടും ഒരു സ്വന്തം അച്ഛന അമ്മമാരി ഒരു നല്ലൊരു ബന്ധം പോലെ നല്ല എന്താ പറയുക
എനിക്ക് എന്നെ സംബന്ധിച്ച് എനിക്ക് രണ്ടാം ജന്മത്തിലൊരു ദൈവം എന്ന് പറയാം.
പിന്നെ അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ എല്ലാം ഈ വരുന്ന തലമുറയ്ക്കും എല്ലാം ഒരു നല്ലൊരു പാഠമായിട്ടും നല്ലൊരു പാഠപുസ്തകമായിട്ടും എല്ലാവർക്കും അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ പ്രവൃത്തിയായാലും ചിന്തകളായാലും എല്ലാം എടുക്കാൻ സാധിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു.
I don't generally come to lay foundation stones, but my friends in Delhi, cutting across political circles, advised me and even requested me, if Arivedan P.V. Ramavariyar has invited you to Coimbatore, we suggest Karan Singh ji that you go there, meet this person who has been a unique personality in the realm of Ayurveda during the 20th century. Krishnakumarji, like his father, was well connected, as all of us know. Wide network he had with people across spectrums, be it political, social and otherwise, like be it from the scene of fine arts, be it from political leaders, bureaucrats, industrialists, people from industry, etc. I think have played a great role in expanding the propagation initiative what Krishnakumarji took up for Ayurveda across the country.
So they all had visited, and there was actually one event for them to perform, either laying the foundation stone or opening the clinical unit of AVP or releasing Ayurveda Chikitsa Margam, the book on Ayurveda Medicines and Therapeutics by founder Ayurvedan P.V. Ramavariyar.
The Chikitsa Margam book, a new edition of it was brought out in the mid-70s. So he took this as a reason to meet Mrs. Gandhi and request her to officially launch this book so that people across the country would notice, an Ayurvedic therapeutic index book. We would call it therapeutic index. So if somebody like Mrs. Gandhi could launch that book, it would give a tremendous visibility, not only to the science, but also considering Ayurveda as a commendable or a well-accepted method of treatment.
चारु रूप जित मदन मनोहर गंध
AVP per se from Arivedyan P.V. Ramavarir's time have been great supporters of all forms of art, because one, it formed part of the Indian Vedic culture, of which Ayurveda is also an integral part. So all these artists were also mutual supporters, mutual fans, I would say, of the Ayurvedic movement. They have also given performances in our campuses to encourage people to come and see what is happening in the Ayurvedic hospital, the Ayurvedic therapy, the Ayurvedic system of education and research, what AVP was involved in.
He was a great believer of karma vipaka. He always said that everything is happening because of a reason. Listen, now, there are methods to prolong it or prevent it or dilute that its reaction.
One of the premier institute working exclusively on DMD or Duchenne muscular dystrophy, AVP is associated and offering treatment for the past almost 5-6 years. So I don't think any other Ayurveda hospital has seen such a range of condition in children suffering from that very rare neurological disease. So there he insisted on providing quality Ayurveda care totally free of cost. At the same time, he also collected the date of birth, place of birth and the birth star and other details of the children, get it assessed by 3 expert astrologers, and also performed the remedial measures totally free of cost. So when we look at this as two disconnected knowledge streams in that, we find it very contradictory in nature. We don't find the possibility of a balance. But for him, it was not two different, science and spirituality were not two disconnected thing. For him, everything was spiritual, no doubt at all. But he could actually balance what was seemingly very extremist in.
Ayurveda has always been an integral part of this knowledge system. So whether you teach Bhagavatam, Narayaniyam, Bhagavad Gita, I think it's no different, or rather very similar, like propagating the knowledge which is imparted by books like Charaka Samhita or Ashtanga Hridaya. Premaji and Krishnakumarji took up this initiative of taking forward the message of our scriptures to the modern English-learned, English-educated community. So the Vishwandu Parishad, the various Hindu platforms, the various social platforms, be it Hindu or otherwise, these are many of the platforms where they were working together in taking forward the message of our Indian traditional knowledge and sciences.
He was very much inspired by many political leaders, not by their philosophy but their characteristics. For example, I tell you, before even I joined, I used to tell me, that's why I know, used to go to Delhi very often. That was why he started his interaction with WHICMR. And one of the main persons helped him is A.K. Gopalan. A.K. Gopalan was a great leader of left Marxist party, and A.K. Gopalan was like his uncle. So he used to take him everywhere, introduce him. So he used it. He also used to go to great leaders like Congress party. He also used to BJP. He was very active in Vishwananda Parishad. Hansi Srinivasa, he was using that for the mission that he is in.
Anything which is good for this country, irrespective of people's religious beliefs, people's political beliefs, their traditions, culture, language, Krishnakumarji would always listen to everyone, absorb, take ideas from them, and he will implement them in many areas. Krishnakumarji was a man of inclusiveness, including everything. Nothing was exclusive. So if you ask me, why did he plan to start a bakery? Well, Ayurveda Pharmacy has got a Nannari Sarbat. Now many people would ask, why would an institution which propagates classical Ayurveda with treatments, therapies, research, academics, venture into something like that? But the science of Ayurveda says there is a little bit or a large part of Ayurveda in everything we consume and eat. Because food or ahar is a very important part of the Ayurvedic science. Having said this, you know, looking at modern Western food items like a bakery or a cake shop, Vishwakumarji always felt there is a chance to include Ayurveda in making a cake a better, more healthier product. If a healthy person could consume a cake, why don't you look at a formula, or why don't you look at a recipe rather, which can bring a cake in the form of, with some Ayurvedic goodness in it. So he believed that Ayurveda worked beyond ailments, beyond sickness. He wanted Ayurveda to be the mainstream lifestyle of a common man.
എല്ലാവരുടെയും ആരോഗ്യം.